say he's crazy for living the life that he leads. He loves what he's doing. He's the last of a dying breed. His days are spent on the range, pushing cattle in the sun and the rain. He does his work with a passion, but most men would just go insane. He's a cowboy inside. That's one thing he'll never hide. It's love for the land. It's about riding. Their own, the open prairie, the only place made for cowboys. Feel free. At night time, you sit there alone, no worries. No cares and no phone. It's hard to understand him. He's rugged and mean, yet so sweet. His days of finding true love are gone. So he figures he must go on. He'll die old, single and free. Man with a legacy. He's a cowboy inside. That's one thing he'll never hide. It's love for the land. It's about riding. Prairie, the only place made for cowboys. Feel free.
Hopes for the future. That kind of stuff. What do you want out of life?
I'd like to be able to have a good herd of cows and a good farm. Have a good reputation. To be able to raise the kids the way they need to be. Give them the opportunity to be the best they can be. Make them work. Know how to work, know how to do a lot of things, to learn from the farm.
Last night we brought the children by to visit their grandpa, and it's plain to see they're truly part of him. And while we were there, their grandma took out some old photographs, and he sure looked a lot like me back then. I'm seeing my father in me. I guess that's how it's meant to be, and I find more and more like him each day. I notice I walk the way he walks. I notice I talk the way he talks. I'm starting to see my father in me.
just to keep us all fed. If I could do things over, I'd live my life again and never take for granted the love in Daddy's hands. Daddy's hands were soft and kind when I was crying. Daddy's hands were hard as steel. Were soft and kind when I was crying. Daddy's hands were hard as steel when I'd done wrong. Daddy's hands were always gentle, but I've come to understand there was always love in Daddy's hands.
Someday, Earl. They'll say, look at Dad. Those are dries, Nick. That bowl doesn't melt. Your 306, very good 86 conductor. I think she's about 11, 12 years old right now. One real fine gal. 41. Classified excellent. Records over 1,000 pounds of fat, over 30,000 pounds of milk. Best cow that's ever been on Creech Farm since. First excellent. Just tie it to the fence, hook it to the fence there.
But we gotta close them back so the little herd can go milk in the morning when mom milks at 1 in the morning.
And on the eighth day, God looked down on his planned paradise and said, I need a caretaker. So God made a farmer. God said, I need somebody willing to get up before dawn, milk cows, work all day in the fields, milk cows again, eat supper, then go to town and stay past midnight at a meeting of the school board. So God made a farmer. I need somebody with arms strong enough to wrestle a calf and yet gentle enough to deliver his own grandchild. Somebody to call hogs, tame cantankerous machinery, come home hungry, have to wait lunch until his wife's done feeding visiting ladies, then tell the ladies to be sure and come back real soon and mean it. So God made a farmer. God said, I need somebody willing to sit up all night with a newborn colt and watch it die, then dry his eyes and say, maybe next year. I need somebody who can shape an axe handle from a persimmon sprout, shoe a horse with a hunk of car tire, who can make harness out of hay wire, feed sacks, and shoe scraps, who planting time and harvest season will finish his 40-hour week by Tuesday noon and then painting from tractor back put in another 72 hours. So God made a farmer. God had to have somebody willing to ride the ruts at double speed to get the hay in ahead of the rain clouds and yet stop in midfield and race to help when he sees the first smoke from a neighbor's place. So God made a farmer. God said, I need somebody strong enough to clear trees and heave bales, yet gentle enough to yean lambs and wean pigs and tend the pink-combed pullets, who will stop his mower for an hour to splint the broken leg of a meadowlark. It had to be somebody who'd plow deep and straight and not cut corners. Somebody to seed, weed, feed, breed, and rake, and disc, and plow, and plant, and tie the fleece, and strain the milk, and replenish the self-feeder, and finish a hard week's work with a 5-mile drive to church. Somebody who'd bale a family together with the soft, strong bonds of sharing. Who would laugh, and then sigh, and then reply with smiling eyes when his son says that he wants to spend his life doing what Dad does. So God made a farmer.
Hold on, Nikki.
It all starts with a family, land and a little seed. Say a prayer that the roots grow deep, 'cause it's all grown naturally. Our home is here in the heartland, where we work and earn these calloused hands. Generations of dedication and honor, the American farmer. There's new ways of harvesting, same crops, bigger machines. Working hard is an everyday thing. That's the way it'll always be. Our home is here in the heartland, where we work and earn these calloused hands. Generations of dedication and honor. We'll be right back.
good herd of cows, but I got a good bunch too.